They're so nice. I never usually buy organic fruit, but this stuff's actually really nice. It's actually on sale. Sometimes it's just too expensive. I forgot I had these tiny little skewers. I should have been using them earlier. So useful. They stick. Look at the size of this. It's as big as my friggin' hand. Jeez. Giant. Tree trunk. Which way I should coat it? Seems kind of hollow there. Think it might fall. There we go. Holy. Honestly, I might need a bigger skewer. Stay. Hope so. Just giant bears. Chewy. So pretty this time. Last time, for some reason, my strawberries were like, they were just crap. These are like really nice this time. My other ones were like too ripe. Hard part's gonna be the raspberries. Cause they're like hollow. So I'm wondering if I could do like blackberry for support. Cause they're probably gonna slide off. This is gonna be like almost impossible to do raspberries. Yo, thanks, dude. I'm excited to do this one. Holy crap. I wonder if I could sneak. I'm only supposed to do in numbers. That's what the legends say. To make some little cute combos. Yeah. I could get my ASMR really popping. I'm working on I saw the videos, I'm gonna use a shorter chair this time, which I'm on now, so that you can see the plate without me having to zoom too far back, so that the background's not like half the footage. I like these time skewers. I'm taking up a lot less room. I'm just gonna figure out what to do with these darn raspberries. because I know they're not gonna want to stay. Raspberry. Hey, no crying. Yeah, that's gonna be a problem. Gonna have to do odd numbers, sorry. Sorry, official people. That'd be awesome. Good start. Well, now that I monetized the video that's made the most money is the ASMR one, so maybe eventually I won't even do compilations that it'll pay me anyways and clips. Like, even my gaming content's not super popular, but maybe I could. I'm popular for ASMR and Tanghulu on other platforms like TikTok and stuff, so. Yeah, these look great. Just gotta figure out. Might have to do some odd number in here. Otherwise, it's just never gonna stay. Because probably blackberries, or not blackberries, raspberries. Blackberries are perfect because they're not hollow, but raspberries, you lose the core when you pick them. So I'm going to have to be doing like a bunch of blackberry-raspberry hybrids, I think. Hey, no crying this time. I already gave her fruit. She's a little greedy little baby. Been eating like a queen. Yeah, that's gonna be sweet. Layla. Whoa. Are you gonna do some ASMR with me? whoa. You get one. Okay. How is it? Good? Okay. Don't be greedy. Such a brat. No. How about some strawberry greens? I'm choked on spit. Want some strawberry greens, Pongo? Honestly, co-op stuff is so expensive, but it's like when you actually get good stuff, it's really nice. I feel like this one's gonna fall off. I can use a big. This one's kind of giving me grief. I knew it was hollow on the inside. Had a bad feeling. This one might be hard to skewer. If I could almost just skewer it this way. Yeah, it feels real meaty. That's good. Sometimes you just gotta skewer. If you're not getting the right angle, you gotta change it. This is because sometimes it's hollow in the middle and you end up getting screwed over. Singles. I'm gonna do a quad or a triple. They say it's like good luck to do even numbers or something like that, traditionally or something. But sometimes it doesn't work out. They do like whole ones. Yeah, you can't always be eating everything I'm eating. I only let you eat fruit and vegetables. Giving her all the strawberry leaves. Here you go. You like a Pongo? She didn't like them. Layla will eat them. Yeah, these strawberries are so cute. Still got their little follicles on. Strawberry hail. Yeah, I gotta master the Blue Yeti. I'm still just working on how to figure it out. It's honestly like just dealing with the noise it picks up everything. It's really tricky. Oh wow, yeah, look at the color on those strawberries, so nice. Nice color. Yeah, I can stick a raspberry or two inside. Oh yeah, look at that, looks good. Hopefully they aren't too long to coat. Sure, all these little hairs will be coming off in my ice. People think they're boogs. I know the blackberries and raspberries are organic. I'm not sure about strawberry. Last time I forgot to grab extra ice too. That was so annoying. Or I forgot to freeze it. Be able to eat this, but I can always save some. No. So, then I'll be boiling my sugar after. What did I make the other one like? Okay. Let's see. I don't know if I'll be able to use all these. Dogs are crying. Poochie, you're not the star of the show every time. You ate all the greens you wanted. There you go. She's a little piggy. Honestly, I'm trying to think of what to do here. This way, I guess. Yeah, honestly, now that I'm monetizing YouTube, I'm gonna be putting out a lot more of this kind of stuff. I usually reserve for TikTok, but since I'm in Canada, I don't get paid, so I'm like, why am I doing it here? May as well do it. I'll still do it on TikTok, but definitely my main thing will be YouTube. Do you have enough greens? There you go. Yeah, I can try raspberry only, but they're definitely just gonna fall. Don't think it's gonna work. Yeah, they feel so fragile. Yeah, they're just gonna fall off. feed them to my hogs. Cups of sugar. How many raspberries I got? I got three. I don't think I'll buy raspberries again. They're just too hard to do. Six, nine, 12. Still got 12. Yeah, that's bad. Oopsie doops. What about sideways? They're just so soft. I would need like a little something to stick them on in the end. This is not that bad, but yeah, they still fall off. It's too bad. This one's even a little more firm. Could try, but I'm sure it'll just fall off in the sugar. Just so much sugar. It's gonna cook. Sugar. Oops, crushed raspberry. One cup of water. Now we transition. I gotta set up everything. Get all my lights on and all that. Quite the process. Extension cord. Ring light. So plug in the dash cord. The blue Yeti. The adapter here. Now I gotta go turn off my furnace and my fridge. Those are gonna be tasty. I gotta get my ice water.
the ice this time. It wasn't clanging around like I usually make it before. Quite the process. Got my sugar thermometer. I gotta plug in the LED and everything. Got all my cords and my ring light. Okay, I gotta go turn off the appliances. All right, fridge is off, furnace is off, sound is almost set up, and I'm gonna have to turn off my stuff to start recording pretty soon, so then you'll be able to see the process here, the fruit and the other camera, and then I got the sugar boiling, and should have no water in there. I got my Bugatti and the adapter and the ring light, and then I'm going to mount it after there when I eat it. So I'll be back. Got the setup. Got the thermometer, which I didn't used to use, but makes things easier. Got all my fruit set up. Got the other camera. Got the sugar boiling. Got the silicone mat. The ice. The Blue Yeti. I got the ring light. And I got the adapter for the Blue Yeti and trigger. And center cord, so takes quite a bit of setup to get this rolling, but got a system at this point. Pretty much you gotta wait for the sugar to reduce to 300 Fahrenheit. And then pretty much start coating. It's gonna be ones like this that'll be easy, but I tried to stay away from the raspberry type stuff, as when they're hollow in the back, they typically just fall off. Got some humongous strawberries here. They're like a baby's fist. It's like a small girl's hand. Holy, that is nuts. And some of them are so cute and tiny. The blackberries are always nice to skewer. It's easy, but yeah. And then pretty much you film all these, and sometimes I film enough for the month, and they'll range from, you know, 10K views, 100K views, sometimes 30 million views. Really depends. Usually in the summer when the kids are off school, honestly, is when you get the most views. So sometimes I'll kind of coast for most of the year, and then in June, July, or whenever kids are off, they usually rip pretty hard. And then, now that I'm doing more ASMR and the mukbang stuff, I get the stand so I can do recording, and then make some money off YouTube. So far, I've only made $5, but I've been monetized for only 3 days, so hoping to do more ASMR content, mukbang stuff. I might even just start doing, like, food reviews and, like, cereal, and, like, I don't know, because when I did live on YouTube, I ate cereal at, like, 150 viewers, like, not concurrent, but, like, total, so I was like, that's pretty good. So, yeah, pretty much, you're supposed to only use odd numbers, but, or even numbers, but there was some I just, like, with the raspberries I had to. Honestly, when it's 2 cups of sugar, too, it takes quite a while, but I'm eventually going to close the live so I can film the coating. So that's the ASMR that everyone really likes, the sounds of the ice and stuff. It's kind of the most popular part. But yeah, been doing this for 3 years now, a total of like 330 million views across, 340 now across all socials, so we're growing, but I neglected YouTube for too long, so now I'm playing catch up. Since TikTok doesn't monetize in Canada, otherwise I would probably make a pretty good chunk of change, but at least there's never too late to start, you know, so. People say, like, oh, I'm eating too much sugar, but I don't eat this that often, as I record all my videos for, you know, in bulk. So, I do this once in a while. Sometimes I'll do it, like, 2 times a week, and sometimes I'll only do it, like, once a month. Because, like, with this, each one of these is going to be a video. So then I'm going to have over, whatever, 20 videos. Then normally I would have another 20 videos of me eating it. And then I'm going to actually condense those all now, just in one video for long form, for YouTube. More of a mukbang style. Did one the other day. It's interesting, when I did mukbang on Redbook, I had a video that had almost 200,000 views, but then, like, on other platforms, I think I've had 700K for one of the ASMR eating on TikTok, but the majority of the views have been the actual coding of it. But, kind of just a process. Takes a while to get down, or your sugar will crystallize, or your fruit's not dry enough, and it, makes the sugar crystallize, or sometimes it's too watery and it doesn't coat properly. It looks simple, but it's kind of like making caramel. It's like a kind of a process behind it. That should be pretty good. Trying to get big on YouTube. I got about almost 12,000 subs now. Got 143,000 on TikTok. About 21,000 on Twitter. 18,000 on Redbook. 4,000 on Like. So in total, I'm almost hitting 200,000 followers now. So we're just growing over time. I'm hoping to get in the millions, like my freaking fiance's brother. He's in the millions already, and his buddy's got like 5 million, so I'm hoping to get to that level where I can be making multiple six figures with the content and sponsorships and stuff, and then I'll have more funds for the brand, Chef Fire Doge and all that, and being able to travel. It'll be sweet. Go to, like, you know, NFT New York and NFT Miami and Vegas and stuff, and just be able to go to, like, Comic-Con and the influencer events would be really cool. At the present moment, I spent all my money on my house, so I don't have money to, like, travel these extravagant events, but I'll get there eventually. can see it's starting to get more reduced or getting there. Maybe next time I'll do a spaces so I can have speakers join and do commentary. That'd be cool. I think that'd be fun, actually. Almost like a, do like a spaces where people can watch me do mukbang. That'd be sweet. Because honestly, like, my visibility hasn't been very high on Twitter, but most of the stuff I'm viral for, like, isn't, like, NFT related. The NFT project was, like, more popular when I was in spaces with, like, people that were, you know, bigger and stuff during the last bull market, but it's been pretty slow since interest rates have been high, so I've been focusing on this, figuring if I get more famous here, eventually, you know, when I got millions of followers, it'll make the NFT project huge. Without me needing to spend millions on marketing when I just become marketing. Similar to how, like, Nelk Boys, they made their own NFT and sold it all just because they have a big podcast and prank channel, so I'm thinking more in that direction. I think it'd be more efficient use of my time. I'm still making music for tracks for the Chepwear Doja. Released a track not too long ago. Some of them are minted on Sound XYZ and some on OpenSea, and then I put them on Spotify and other socials. But I'm really trying to figure out exactly what'll be the main vehicle of getting music out in the future. If I'm really huge, maybe I'll just be like Snoop Dogg and pull it all on my NFTs only. But for now, I'm kind of just like, I'm just hitting every social media platform, hitting it from all angles. Then yeah, just doing lots of live, lots of content, and still doing gaming content and ASMR, and then, you know, of course doing some lifestyle stuff with my fiance and dogs and all that. It should be pretty good. Pretty excited how things have been going. Making good progress with my followers and views. Even though it's almost like a chart, the returns are lumpy. You don't get all the views at once. There's ebbs and flows and seasonality and stuff, so more of a summer account now, so I'm trying to expand so I can kind of have every month be popping, which it's been good for Redbook and YouTube, but TikTok's really seasonal just because of school, and my audience is like 80% female on TikTok, where on YouTube it's like 70 or 80% male, so it's quite the difference, which is interesting. And honestly, it doesn't really matter what platform I'm good on, but I would rather be on the ones that pay you, of course, you know? Because TikTok exposure is kind of hard to cross over to other platforms, where it would be a lot easier to market my NFTs on YouTube and all that when my project's big. Oh, I better get set up here. The last 50 degrees goes really fast, so I shall tune in later and post the results. Get back.
behemoth. Like a candied apple.
Holy crap.
Oops.
Beautiful, beautiful. I'm shaking. Okay. Thank you.
sugar. It's a close call.
Hey, no barking.
I'm losing it. This one's a dud. Crap. Wah, wah, wah. This one fell. I don't think I'm gonna get them all. Yeah. Oh, back in it, squirrels. Get it. Come on. I can't get them all. Just get the two on the end. Oh. Oh. There's my ring light time up. I'm out. Oh, that's pretty good. I almost got all of them. beauty. All right. Now, my phone's getting hot. This to my account. Hey, that.
You had it out? Just a squirrel.
It'll be part of the set. The loud stinking dogs. Alright.
This is the full service deal here.
Okay. Try this one in. Cinematic.
The night before I was eating here, now, I was eating too high up. I was eating like here, my chair was higher. Now I think if I do this, Fudge. Yeah.
Well, the alarm has ended my video, so. Honestly, I think I'm gonna save these. Well, my alarm just cut off my mukbang video, but I'm pretty damn full. I think I'm gonna save some of these for my friend. I said I would, so. That was good, that was a lot of food.
That's fun.
There you go. Save the rest for mom.
Well, time for cleanup. Honestly, I might have so many skewers now that I'm just gonna throw them away.
I'm balling now.
Baller.
Be balling up in this.
Boing.
Now it's time to clean up. And, unassemble my
camera setup and everything. My Yeti and my attachment and my freaking gooseneck stand and my
ring light and the extension cord and the charger. Well, it was fun. Now I have behind the scenes of how I do it. I'll be sure to upload this to the YouTubes as well. Goodbye.